everybody. It's Robin, and I have taken a little break from the 10 and 10s this summer, and it's time to get them started again. It's September. It's kind of like, it feels like a new year. September always feels like sort of the start to a new year to me, you know, with the kids going to school and all that good stuff. And I think it's the perfect time to get the 10 and 10s going again. So, we're going to do a nice kind of general movement series today. I am going to have some light weights. I've got 5-pound weights. You don't have to have the weights, but if you've got something to hang on to for a little bit of extra oomph, go ahead and do that. So here's where we're going to start. We're just going to have 1 foot forward. We're going to take those arms straight down and straight up like that. And we're going to do that for a whole minute with that 1 foot forward, okay? So I'm going to stand to the side for just a sec. So you can see, a lot of times I see people arching their backs there. We don't need to do that, okay? Just swing those arms down, keep your tummy tight, and reach high toward the sky, okay? Don't worry about arching back. That's where we get into trouble, especially if we've got this stride stance going. Because then the low back kind of overdoes it, and there's not a lot of room to overdo it, okay? So just a nice easy swing. You're staying in this stride stance. We've got about 10 more seconds there on this side. There we go. I do love having just a little bit of weight in the hands for that one because it really helps to fire up the core. Okay, we're going to go ahead and switch sides. So other foot forward, swing down, swing back up. That's it. Same thing here. Be aware that you're not arching your back there, okay? If you feel any pinching or something funky in that low back, chances are you're arching, okay? Just bring those arms straight up. Think tall and long, lifting through the ribs, creating some space. That's what a lot of these strength and flexibility movements that we do here at Be Fit and with the 10 and 10s and with our programs online and in person is lengthen, strengthen, and create space. Okay? And it feels so much better to be lengthened and strengthened. There we go. See? We're off to a great start. All right. Next move is going to be, if you've got the weights in your hand, you're going to take a backward step and reach down. You're just going to come here, reach overhead. We might go for a little balance there. Backward step, reach down, go for some balance. Now, when we're doing that backward step, if you're reaching down toward the floor, you're going to get a nice little stretch through those hamstrings. Okay? And then we're going to have to get stable right away to balance. So that's a really nice combination. Going from a lengthening back there to a stabilizing balanced position here. And again, we're going to do each leg for about a minute, so you keep going. I'm just going to check the watch. Only a couple more seconds left. So let's go ahead and switch. Take that other leg, step it backward, reach down, come up. I'll give you the side view in just a second, okay? So you can see what I'm doing with that back leg. I'm just kind of bringing it back. I don't even have my full foot on the floor. I'm reaching down, and I'm coming back to this balance. That's it. Well, let's get ourselves going there. Nicely done. Isn't that feel good? I love these 10-minute segments, right? So many of my clients here at Be Fit use these 10-minute segments as a sort of adjunct to what we're doing individually, and it makes a huge difference to get your body moving in all these different directions for just 10 minutes a day, okay? It can snowball into some really great things. It might spur you on to do a little bit more, or it might be exactly just what you need for that day, and that's fine, okay? All right. Next move is going to be a lateral lunge. Reach down to crossing over, okay? If the crossing over doesn't feel quite right, you can just go right to here. That would be fine too. But if the crossing over feels okay, let's do it. Okay? Just a nice reach down and a nice reach up. This lateral move here is one that many of us don't challenge all that often. And as a physical therapist, I see one of the things that I see with people with back pain and knee pain is they've lost a lot of motion in this lateral plane, okay? So, how do we get the motion back? We just do it, we practice it, right? We gotta challenge ourselves a little bit. Switch sides. Take the other leg off to the side, come here and cross over and reach up. This leg off to the side, cross over and reach up. That's it. Nice and easy. We got it. Okay? If we don't challenge ourselves, we can't change. No challenge, no change. Right? And if we don't challenge our bodies, they change in the wrong direction. We get tighter, stiffer, weaker, more stooped. If we challenge ourselves to strengthen and lengthen, we change in the right direction. Because let's face it, we all have things we want to do. Okay? And we want to be able to do them for a long, long time. So getting our bodies and our minds ready to go and take on this motion, put it to use, that's what we need. It's good medicine. One more. Perfect. Okay, guys. We just have a couple more exercises to go. I'm just taking a look at my watch. The next one is going to be this. We're going to take another forward step, okay? Lots of lunges today. Reach down and across, then come on back, step backward and up. Down and across with that lunge step, backward and up. That's it. Nice high reach, okay? Nice cross body move there, nice high reach here. That's it. We're going to get a little rotation for the last move, okay? We're going to do this for a minute on each side. There we go. That's it. And notice how my head is not disappearing down like this, okay? So when we come forward like that, we want to keep that back nice and neutral. You can still see my face. You can still see my chest. And we're coming back up. That means we're strengthening those spinal muscles. We're working on the core and the hips and the upper back all together. All right, time to switch sides. Lunge, reach across, step backward and reach up. Reach down and across, step backward and reach up. There we go. That's it. And that backward step, with that reach up, again, we're not trying to arch back, we're just reaching for the sky. Step forward and down, back and up. That's it. Keep that going. Oh, you got it. Just going to check my watch. We're going to do a couple more of those. There we go. You're almost done. You're 10 minutes. All right, guys. Here's the last move. We're just going to take an open step, kind of swing those arms around this way, swing them back up this way. Swing here, swing here. Now, this does not have to be some big backward move here, okay? We're just a nice open step with the arms moving. Come on back up top. Open step, easy swing, come on back. That foot that's on the floor, you may notice, isn't moving, okay? It's glued right down. So I'm not pivoting like this. Okay, that stance foot is down and it's staying down that way. We get some nice length happening through that inner thigh, the front of the hip. We get a good, easy rotation going, okay? That's it. We're going to go ahead and switch sides. Take that other foot, swing it open, come back up. Swing it open, come back up. This is the last move. This is 10 of 10 in 10 minutes. Who doesn't have 10 minutes? I dare say, if someone says they don't have 10 minutes to do a little bit of movement, you might need to make 10 minutes. Everybody's got 10 minutes. We can find it, okay?
something for ourselves. And that right there can make all the difference in your day, in your week, in your year, in your month. All right, guys, welcome back to the 10 and 10. We'll be doing them weekly again, just a little summer hiatus, but good to see everybody. If you have a request for anything on the 10 and 10s, write me a little comment, write me a little note. We're getting done. All right. Great job, everybody.